Hi everyone, welcome back to this week's episode of Tuesday Tips. Today what we're going to do is focus on the third part of our conversation series. This is going to be our final one, but we really want to focus on the additional things that you can do in the settings tab once you're starting to think about how you want your conversations to work for the people that are coming to your page. So you'll see here we're in the general. We have all of our notifications enabled, but what we really want to focus on is the welcome message and then the roles. So our welcome message is going to be exactly what appears in this little pop-up. You have the opportunity to either turn it on or turn it off. If you have it off, you'll just see this in the bottom of your screen. Not everybody knows that that's a chat bot. So I always like the welcome message. I think it's a really good way to, you know, get the attention of the people that are visiting your page and letting them know that you're available for them through this chat bot. So you can see here, you can actually choose how you want this to appear. Your body text is going to be the second line that you see here, which is my sentence that I've written there. It doesn't have to exist if you don't want it to. I typically like this one with the wave, welcome to Boone's Bandanas, how can we help you? You'll see here that our color system is defined based on Boone's Bandanas branding, but you can really just start to welcome individuals and make them aware of your chatbot. That way, you know, you're sending them a proactive message in order to just get their attention. You can start then to kind of tweak it if you want it to be round, if you want it to be a sharp rectangle, whatever you prefer, but that's really how you set up your welcome messaging. So now that we're done with that, we're gonna go ahead and click publish. The other thing that we wanna talk about is actually going to be roles. So you'll see I have 20 seats of my conversations and I have 16 of them open because I only have 4 of my users assigned as agents. So all of my users are part of the admin group, but typically only 3 of them are actually going to need to be interacting within conversations as they're more focused on the support of the business side. So we have Emily and Courtney and then Danny as agents. Nobody is in view only. It's either an agent or they can't access it. So you have the opportunity to say, you know, Shiv might not need to actually do something with them within conversations, but I would like him to just be able to view any of the chats and things that are happening. So you can really determine how you want that to work out. So you have really, through the roles, through the chatbot automation that we talked about last week, through our welcome messaging, really customize this to match your tone and the way that you want it to work for your business. Now that you're ready to start using conversations, especially after talking about the unified inbox a couple weeks ago, you can dive in and start really making these experiences great for your contacts. If you've tweaked the welcome messaging or have anything that you want to talk about as far as roles, or even just conversations in general, let us know in the comments and we'd love to hear from you. Otherwise, we'll talk again next week. Thanks so much.